Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to review a Netflix series and a quite new one called Ripley, which is based on Patricia Highsmith's book The Talented Mr. Ripley, which I also have been adapted many times. And this is but for first time in a, as a TV series, and I think it was written and directed by Stephen Salian or something like, I think he's called that, who has also written a lot of great scripts beforehand and also directed some few movies. But he really have done an outstanding job adapting the book to this limited series. I remember when there was a read about they were going to make a TV series based on the talent Mr. Ripley, I was kind of a bit surprised since it was been adapted sometimes before, and especially the 1999 film with Matt Damon, that was really critical acclaim. So I was curious if they could sort of bring a new take on it, but they really do. And it's outstanding how it looks and feels, and just the environments or the sort of the interiors and exteriors. All the locations looks absolutely fantastic, and I think they really capture the essence of Italy in 1960s really. And just also how the music is that's played, and how the actors are wearing their clothes and looks, you really feel sense of authenticity, and the series is just so incredible casted, and they, what I like about it is that they all the actors you kind of know, but they are not the most famous actors in the world. They are not Jude Law or Matt Damon or Gwyneth Paltrow like in the 1999 film, but Andrew Scott is probably the most famous of the actors, but he's still not I don't think many people would completely remember his name, so he still, but he has of course get recognition in the last couple of years, and he's absolutely fantastic as Ripley, because he's so sinister and charming at the same time. He has that feel, look in his eyes, you know, he can sort of look with very intense expression, and from one moment to another he can just be a charming and smiles, and he's such a great, it's really a wonderful performance he delivers, and I think he's the best Ripley I've seen. Yeah, but the other actors are incredible as well, and it's really fun to see there's so many Italian actors in this. They really have done something to sort of make it realistic, to get very many Italian actors, and especially the inspector, I can't remember his name, but he's also has a great face and plays absolutely fantastic. And it's really like it's a series that use a lot of time of develop the characters, but also sort of see almost how Ripley thinks in terms of what is going to happen now, you know. Is he going to do something criminal, or does he just want to lie? You sort of get a sense of how he thinks, and how the series also takes a lot of time of not necessarily go too much into the murder scenes itself, but the aftermath, you know, that, you know, if you have if you know the story, you do know there's some murders that happen in the story, and what I really like is that it takes so much time to just see how he gets away with dealing with what should he do with the bodies really, and it's really an interesting thing, because when you see films and series nowadays, you see a crime series or thriller, when it almost looks like murder is easy, they just kill them, and then suddenly next scene they are in the wood and they bury the body, you know, and this series really capture that it's not that easy, you know. I think I read an interview with the director. He said something like, when he wanted to write the script for the series, he said that the feeling that murder is quite easy, but it's not easy to get away with the murder or sort of the aftermath. That's the hard part, and sort of I get what his point is in terms of what he sort of showed in the series, and he really is a really well written series, but it's also have a lot of just visual storytelling really, where something isn't necessarily said, but you just see what happens, and it has a film noirish feeling, but also a sense of suspense, almost like it was a Hitchcock film or series. But you can definitely see the homages to the great stuff that were back in the 40s, and also a bit of the 50s, 60s in terms of if you look at Hitchcock. And I think the reason I really want to talk about this series is like, you know, sure, it has been, this book has been adapted many times, but you can actually do it again and do it quite well if you really capture the essence of the book it's based on, but still do something new with it. This feels timeless. This feels like a series that could be made over 60 years ago. And yeah, and I think it could also be looked on 60 years from now, I would imagine. And I just really want to recommend it, because I think this one really deserves to be watched more than maybe the normal typical stuff that are on Netflix or Disney Plus or all the streaming service. I think it's wonderful. I would highly recommend it, and just watch it for a great sort of experience. Even though if you know the story quite well, I think you will enjoy it. And if you haven't, then I also think you would enjoy it, even though it's very thrilling and also a bit grotesque in its nature. And but it also have a grotesque sense of humor, a bit dark. And I kind of like it, that it has a bit tongue-in-cheek, like Hitchcock would say. There should always be a sense of humor when you're dealing with sort of a crime situation. Thank you so much for watching this video, and let me know in the comments if you have seen Ripley already, and I hope you will all have a very nice day.